Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. My dear students, here is your mathematics teacher Muhammad Amjad Saeed from Pakistan International School, Dhaka. Today we will continue our lecture number 69 and exercise 6.10. Last time we finished our question number 13. 14 and 15 are same, but remember that it's very important. In question number 14, g is less than 0. It means that you will take minus ab under root. G is equal to minus ab under root. And other all are same, everything is same. In question number, that was question number 15. In question number 15, g is less than 0. You will take that one. And in question number 14, g is greater than 0. Yes. Question number 14, g is greater than 0, you will take g is equal to plus ab under root. This is the difference in these two questions. Otherwise, each and every term, every step is same. So I hope that you understood this. So I am taking part number 15. Question number 15, part 2. Question number 15, AGH. Find AGH and show that A is less than G is less than H. G is less than 0. In question number 15, G is less than 0. Dear students, part number 2 is A is equal to minus 2 over 5 and B is equal to minus 8 over 5. First of all, this is very important result. So what about A? A is equal to A plus B over 2. Minus 2 over 5 minus 8 over 5 over 2. That is minus 10 over 5. Over 2 as it is. Minus 2 minus 8 is minus 10 and 5 is written down. Here is 2, 2 1 2, 2 1 2, this is minus 1. So arithmetic mean is minus 1. G is less than 0 mean, we will take minus AB under root. AB is minus 2 over 5, minus 8 over 5. That is equal to minus minus plus 16 over 25. 16 over 25 is 4 over 5. And that is equal to 0.8. And this is the negative sign. Outside, that was negative sign in fact. After that, harmonic mean is 2ab over a plus b. 2 into A is minus 2 over 5, minus 8 over 5, minus 2 over 5, minus 8 over 5. Here. So, dear students, we have minus minus plus 32 over 25 over minus 10 over 5. That will be 32 over 25 multiplied by minus 5 over 10. You will take reciprocal of that. Here is 5, 5 the, and this will be minus 32 over 50. Dear students, minus 32 over 50, we can have 32 divided by 50. This is minus 0.64. You can check what is the value of arithmetic mean minus 1. Value of geometric mean is minus 0.8 and value of quadratic mean is minus 6.64. So you can check as minus 1 is less than minus 0.8 is less than minus 0.64. Hence, A is less than G is less than H. That is proof of your answer. I hope that you understood this question. Dear students, after that we have question number 17 and 18. In case of question number 17, if the positive geometric mean and harmonic mean between two numbers are 4 and 16 over 5, find the numbers. Exercise 6.12, rather 10, and we have last two questions, and after this, inshallah, we will start our chapter number 8. I will complete chapter number 7 afterwards. It is related to statistics subject. So first I want to cover your those portions which are directly related to your mathematics subject. So inshallah, first we will cover the next level, chapter 8, 9, 10, like that. And after that we will complete our chapter 7. Don't worry, we will finish our chapter 7 at the end. Now we have question number 7. The question is, if the positive geometric mean is 4 of two numbers, let the two numbers be A and B. It is given that positive geometric mean is 4. This is 4 is equal to AB under root. Scaling 16 is equal to AB. This is your equation number 1. After that, harmonic mean between the numbers is 16 over 5. Also, harmonic mean is 16 over 5 is equal to 2 AB over A plus B. This is our formula. So dear students, we have 16 into A plus B is equal to 12 AB. Actually this is cross multiplication. Here is cross multiplication. 16 into A plus B is equal to 5 to the 10, 10 AB. Using equation 1. What is equation 1? AB is equal to 16. Here in equation 1. So 16 into A plus B is equal to 10 into 16. 16 are cancelled out. So a plus b is equal to 10 and b is equal to 10 minus a. This may be taken as equation number 2. Using this value of b in equation number 1, using b in equation number 1, a into 10 minus a is equal to 16, 10a minus a square is equal to 16, 0 is equal to a square minus 10a plus 16. So dear students, make the pairs a to the 16 and minus a minus 2 is minus 10. Here we will have a into a minus 8 minus 2 into a minus 8 is equal to 0. A minus 8 into a minus 2 is equal to 0. A minus 8 is equal to 0 and a minus 2 is equal to 0. A is equal to 8 and a is equal to 2. If a is equal to 8, then b is equal to 10 minus 8 is equal to 2. 8 and 2. This is your first possibility of your answer. If a is equal to 2, then b is equal to 10 minus 2 is equal to 8. That is 2 and 8. This is your second possibility. Dear students, that was your question number 17. After that, last question of your exercise, we will solve it. We have to find the sequence. The question is, if the numbers 1 over 2, 4 over 21, 1 over 36 are subtracted from the 3 consecutive terms of GP, then the resulting numbers are in harmonic progression. Find the numbers if their product is 1 over 27. We have to find the numbers. And these three numbers are consecutive terms of GP. Let the three numbers in GP are AR square. According to first condition, if these numbers, and from these numbers, 1 over 4, 4 over 21, 1 over 36 are subtracted, then this sequence will become harmonic sequence. Then a minus 1 over 4, ar minus 4 over 21, a minus 1 over, no, it is not 1 over 4, actually it is 1 over 2, yes, a minus 1 over 2, ar minus 4 over 21, and AR square minus 1 over 36. AR square minus 1 over 36 are in harmonic progression. 2a minus 1 over 2, 21 ar minus 4 over 21, 36 ar square minus 1 over 36 are in harmonic progression. Dear students, I told you, if the terms are reciprocal, then these terms will be in arithmetic progression. Therefore, 2 over 2a minus 1, 21 over 21 ar minus 4, 36 over 36 ar square minus 1 are in arithmetic progression. If these terms are in arithmetic progression, then by definition, common difference remains the same. Second minus first is equal to third minus second. 36 over 36 ar square minus 1 minus 21 over 21 ar minus 4. Dear students, you can take it as equation number 1. According to second condition, product is equal to 1 over 27. So what is product? A into AR square is equal to 1 over 27. That is A cube R cube is equal to 1 over 27. AR whole cube is equal to 1 over 3 whole cube, taking cube root on both sides. So 3 and 1 over 3 are cancelled out. AR is equal to 1 over 3. R, A is equal to 1 over 3 R. This is equation number 2. Dear students, this value of A is 1 over 3. You will apply this value of A here, and here. And after simplifying and calculating, you will find the value in terms of R. Then you will put the values of R and you will get two types of values of R. So you will take value of R here and put here to find the value of A. Again, I am repeating. Dear students, using this value of A here, equation number 1, here, and here. And after simplifying, you will get two values of R, two sets of values of R. Then one by one you will apply the value of R here, you will find value of A. Then these values of A and R will be applied here. AR square. In this way you can find the three terms in GP. The future terms in GP. I hope that after putting this value of A here, you simplify and you can get the value of R. And after putting here, you will get the value of A. So I hope that you can complete this question. Dear students, after that, as I told you, I am going to have chapter number 8. In case of chapter number 8, this is an interesting chapter, a little bit lengthy question. Chapter number 8, Mathematical Inductions and Binomial Theorem. This is our topic of your next chapter. Here we have Mathematical Induction and Binomial Theorem. What is mathematical induction? the correctness of the formulas, just like in chapter number 6, we have finished arithmetic mean, arithmetic progression, geometric mean, geometric progression, and harmonic mean. All these formulas will be proved with the help of mathematical induction. So you can say mathematical induction is the procedure with the help of which we can confirm the correctness of the formula. We can check every formula in this method whether it is correct or wrong. That is known as mathematical induction. Chapter number 8. Even in other branches, in physics and in chemistry, the formulas can be proved with the help of this method, mathematical induction. We have chapter number 8. There are 3 exercises. We have 8.1 exercise. Use mathematical induction to prove the following formulas for every positive integers n. What is the procedure to prove the formula? Dear students, listen carefully. Whenever you want to prove the formula, you will check, this is condition number 1, you will check the formula is true for n is equal to 1. You will check whether the formula is true for n is equal to 1. Then you suppose n is equal to k, it is also true. You will suppose that for n is equal to k, this formula is also true. Then, this is condition number 2. Then condition number 3 is, and most important and the main body of your question is, we have to prove that for n is equal to k plus 1, n is equal to k plus 1, to prove that the formula is true for n is equal to k plus 1. Dear students, this is the general method, general technique to prove the formulas. For example, in 8.1 exercise, question number 2 is given. 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus so on plus 2n minus 1 is equal to n squared. Yes, we have to prove this formula that it is true. For n is equal to 1, then we will suppose that n is equal to k, it is true. Then we will prove that n is equal to k plus 1, it is also true. We have to prove it. Let n is equal to 1. Where n is involved, you will put this value here. So you will have 2 into 1 minus 1 is equal to 1 squared. 2 minus 1 is equal to 1 squared is 1. 1 is equal to 1. Left hand side is equal to right hand side. So you will write down the sentence. So formula is true for n is equal to 1. Let us consider it is true for n is equal to k. That is 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus so on plus 2k minus 1 is equal to k squared. This is equation number 1. Dear students, for n is equal to 1, it was true. Formula is true for n is equal to 1. Let us consider it is true for n is equal to k. That is 1 plus 3 plus 5 and so on. 2k minus 1, and this is k squared. We have to prove that we have to prove that it is also true for n is equal to k plus 1. Dear students, here is k. To find the term which is required, again I am repeating, listen carefully, to find the term which is required to make this statement true, for n is equal to k plus 1, you will take always left hand side and last term and put k plus 1 in terms of, in place of k. Here is 2 into k plus 1 minus 1. Remember that this n is equal to k plus 1 I have used here, k in place of k, I have written k plus 1. 2 is constant, minus 1 is constant, so it will be 2k plus 2 minus 1 and 2k plus 1. Dear students, this is your required term. This is your required next term which involves k plus 1. This is your required term which involves k plus 1, and this is added in both sides of equation number 1. Adding 2k plus 1 on both sides of equation number 1. Left hand side, automatically you will have this k plus 1 in fact, by writing this. But on right hand side, you will bring k plus 1 in place of n. That is our requirement, n is equal to k plus 1. You have to bring it. This is 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus so on plus 2k minus 1 plus 2k plus 1 is equal to k square plus 2k plus 1. Dear students, you have added 2k plus 1 on both sides to get next term. Left hand side, it is already made. We have in fact left hand side k plus 1 is made here. But right hand side we have to write down in the proper shape. You can see, what is k square plus 2k plus 1? Is it not k plus 1 whole square? Open up this formula, k square plus 2k plus 1. So k plus 1 whole square, and what is this? In place of n, you got that k plus 1. So dear students, only with this step we reach your answer. After that you will write down, so what is true for n is equal to k is also true for n is equal to k plus 1. Hence, formula is true for all positive integral values of n. So that is your last statement to prove this formula. So what is true for n is equal to k is also true for n is equal to k plus 1. Hence formula is true for all positive integral values of n, or for all positive integers n. That is same. I hope that you understood this question. Dear students, after that we have question number 5. Same technique, question number 5. sentences will be written after every step. These are important. And remember that every question includes these lines. Question number 5. 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 4 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 4 plus so on plus 1 over 2 minus 1 2 power minus 1 2 power n. 2 into 1 minus 2 power 1 minus 1 over 2 power n. Dear students, same technique. Let n is equal to 1. 1 over 2 into 1 minus 1. 2 into 1 minus 1, 2 power 1. 2 into 1 minus 1 over 2 is actually 1 over 2. 2 cancel out, this is 1. 1 over 2 power 0. Remember that something power 0 is always 1. So 1 is equal to 1. So formula is 2. For n is equal to 1. Let us consider it is 2 for n is equal to k. That is 1 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 4 plus so on plus 1 over 2 power k minus 1. 2 into 1 minus 1 over 2 power k. This is equation number 1. We have to prove that. To prove that it is also true for n is equal to k plus 1. Dear students, just like the previous question, you can see the last term of this series on left hand side, you will replace k by k plus 1. Here, k. You will replace k by k plus 1 to get next term. 1 cancel out 1 over 2 power k. Dear students, this is your next term including k plus 1. So 1 over 2 power k is added on both sides in equation number 1. Adding 1 over 2 power k on both sides of equation 1. Dear students, we will have here yes, plus 1 over 2 power k minus 1 plus 1 over 2 power k is equal to 2 into 1 over 2 power k plus 1 over 2 power k. 1 over 2 power k is added on both sides of this equation number 1. Left hand side is already made. This is the term involving k plus 1. So only right hand side will have the proper shape. 2 minus 2 over 2 power k plus 1 over 2 power k. Dear students, our target is to bring k plus 1 here. Left hand side as it is. You will take 2 power k LCM. 2 into 2 power k. 2 power k cancelled out. We are left with minus 2. This is cancelled with left with plus 1. Left hand side as it is. 2 into 2 power k minus 1 over 2 power k. Yes. Dear students, multiplying above and below by 2. Remember that basis same powers are added. 2 power 1, 2 power k, 2 power k plus 1, minus 1. Here multiply 2 above and below. Here. So we will have 2 into 2 power k plus 1 minus 1 over 2 power k plus 1. Remember that here the bases same, so powers are added. Dear students, after that we can have left hand side as it is. 2 power k plus 1 over 2 power k plus 1 minus 1 over 2 power k plus 1. This 2 power k plus 1 was under both terms. So distribute them. You can have 2 into 1 minus 1 over 2 k plus 1. Dear students, in your question, what was your right hand side? 2 into 1 minus 1 over 2 power n. That was your right hand side of your given question. And I told you we have to bring n is equal to k plus 1 in your answer. So we draw that. After this, you will write down. So what is true for n is equal to k? What is true for n is equal to k is also true for n is equal to k plus 1. Hence, formula is true for all positive integral values of n. Dear students, that is your result, and these lines are important. You have to write down these lines. Actually, these are the conclusion, announcement of the conclusion, that what is true for n is equal to k is also true for n is equal to k plus 1. Hence, formula is true for all positive integral values of n. In this way, we will finish our question. I hope that you understood this question. Dear students, you can revise at home, and if you have any problem, you can contact me. Inshallah, we'll do it. Okay, Allah Hafiz, and Assalamu alaikum.